मोशंस ऑफ द अर्थ ऑल वी नो वी हैव रेड इन आवर अर्लियर क्लास ऑल्सो अर्लियर चैप्टर्स ऑल्सो कि ऑल द प्लैनेट्स हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ मोशंस दे हैव रोटेशन एंड रिवोल्यूशन रोटेशन मीन्स दे मूव ऑन देयर ओन एक्सिस एज वेल एज दे मूव अराउंड द स्टार द सन ऑन अ फिक्स्ड पाथ द पाथ इज कॉल्ड ऑर्बिट दैट इज कॉल्ड रिवोल्यूशन रिवोल्यूशन एंड रोटेशन दीज आर द टू मोशंस ऑफ द अर्थ एंड दीज टू मोशंस अफेक्ट ऑन द अर्थ differently all these things we will see in this chapter all we know the shape of the earth is spherical and it revolves as well as rotate on its axis the axis of the earth is not vertical it is not vertical it is inclined the axis is not vertical it is inclined it is inclined on its orbital plane is the plane on which it moves around the sun and the axis is the imaginary line which passes through the center of the earth on which it rotates so this axis when we walk on the earth surface we walk straight we stand vertically on the earth and walk but earth our earth does not remains perpendicular vertical on its orbital plane it remains slanting it is inclined let you see the result of that rotation we define rotation as the movement of the earth on its axis and the movement of the earth around the sun on fixed path or orbit that is called revolution The axis of the earth which is an imaginary line makes an angle of 66 and half degree with its orbital plane the plane formed by the orbit is known as orbital plane we will see in our next diagram someone of you have kept your mic unmute The earth receives light from the sun all we know or due to spherical shape of the earth only half of it get light from the sun at a time due to this spherical shape when sun rays fall only half portion receive light or another half portion remains away from the sun the circle that divides the earth into two halves night and day the part which faces toward the sun experience day and the part remains away from the sun experience night that line which divides the earth into two halves called circle of illumination divides the earth into day and night part the circle does not coincide with the axis as you have seen in this previous figure as well as you will see in the next figure in next page the earth takes about 24 hours to complete one rotation around its axis and the period of rotation is known as the earth day so the earth day is of how much time 24 hours This is the daily motions of the earth. It is daily motion of the earth. Rotation is called daily motion of the earth. Or one complete rotation is called one earth day, or earth completes one rotation in 24 hours, and rotation causes day and night. The part of the earth which faces toward the sun experiences day, while the part which remains away from the sun experiences night. See in the diagram. This diagram is showing circle of illumination. The earth axis is not perpendicular, not vertical on its orbital plane. Here you see orbital plane, this plane on which it moves. This earth is not vertical on its orbit, or that is why the circle of illumination which divides the earth into day and night part, it does not coincide with axis. If axis would be perpendicular on this, then it can coincide, but as it is slanting, or it makes an angle with its orbital plane, it makes an angle. This angle is of 66.5 degrees. It is inclined how much? 23.5 degrees. It is inclined on its orbital plane. The axis is inclined 23.5 degrees. Must remember. And it make an angle with its orbital plane, that is 66.5 degrees. Now listen, there is a question. What would happen if the earth did not rotate? The portion of the earth facing the sun would always experience day, thus bringing continuous warmth to the region, or the region become very hot, and the other half would remain in darkness and be freezing cold all the time. Means this part remains hot, this part remains cold all the time. Or in this condition, life won't be possible on the earth. So that is one of the factor. Life is found on the earth, a temperature remains moderate. Sometime place face sun get heated, and sometime remains away, heat escape from the area, making the condition moderate. So life is found in it. I think up to here it is clear. Next motion is called revolution. The earth move around the sun in its orbit. Orbit means the path. The path on which it move called revolution. Earth takes 365.4 days, means 1 year, to revolve around the sun. As it is not possible to take this 1/4 part of the day also, so for our convenience we consider a year as consisting of only 365 days. We ignore 6 hours, 24 multiplied by 4, 6 hours. So we ignore 6 hours for the sake of our convenience. Or this 6 hours get added, as you have read earlier also, okay, this 6 hours get added in every next years, or in every 4th year, this extra 6 hours become 24 hours, that is equal to 1 day. So that one extra day get added in the month of February. All you know, February is only of 28 days in an ordinary years, but in every 4 years, February is having 29 days, and the year is of 366 days, or the year is called leap year. The leap year is of 366 days, and ordinary year is of 365 days. Now see this diagram. This diagram clearly explains about the effect of revolution of the earth around the sun. As we saw, rotation causes day and night, while revolution causes seasons. how seasons are experienced. We can understand with the help of this diagram. As the must remember one fact, seasons occur because of two factors. One is movement of the earth around the sun, means revolution. One reason is revolution, and second reason is inclination of the earth's axis, inclination of the earth's axis on its orbital plane. So these are the two factors responsible for occurrence of seasons on the earth. Now see the position of the earth to the sun at different part on its orbit and what is the impact of it. When sun rays fall, position of the earth is to this side of the sun, when north pole is inclined toward the sun. What happened? Let you see. When north pole is inclined toward the sun and south pole is away from it. North pole is inclined, and what is the result? See, this is equator. Equator which divides the earth into two halves, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Which hemisphere, larger part of which hemisphere remains to the day side? See, from here to here, this much part remains away from the sun, means this much part remains away from towards the sun. This much part means larger part of northern hemisphere remains toward the sun, and very small part, only this much part remains toward the sun in southern hemisphere. Means days are longer and nights are shorter. For very short period of time, this part goes to the night side. While in southern hemisphere, larger part of southern hemisphere remains to the darker side, or very smaller part remains to the lighter side. So day is shorter and nights are longer. Means in both hemisphere, seasons occur differently. In northern hemisphere, days are longer and nights are shorter, means it is summer. While in southern hemisphere, days are shorter and nights are longer, means it is winter season. Or it happens when sun rays fall vertically over sea, Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degree latitude, 23.5 degree north latitude, that is Tropic of Cancer. This time sun rays falls vertically on Tropic of Cancer, not on equator, on Tropic of Cancer. So larger part of northern hemisphere experience day longer day and shorter night. So it is called summer solstice, or that occurs on 21st June. On that day, sun rays is maximum slanting on Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn, here it is Tropic of Capricorn. So it is maximum slanting, means very less heat reach to the Tropic of Capricorn. So it is winter solstice in southern hemisphere. When it is summer solstice in northern hemisphere, it is winter solstice in southern hemisphere. Again, it moves and come to 23rd September. Of see the position of earth to the sun during this. Sun rays fall vertically, neither northern hemisphere nor southern hemisphere, inclined toward the sun. Neither northern hemisphere nor southern hemisphere inclined toward the sun. And what is the result of this? Is sun rays fall vertically over equator. Sun rays fall vertically over equator means sun rays equally get distributed in all the hemisphere. Circle of illumination. See, circle of illumination on that day passes through both north pole and south pole. North pole and south pole. It is the time when north pole and south pole shift from, see here, North Pole never goes to the darker side. When on 21st June, North Pole never goes to the darker side. It remains day all the time. On this day, North Pole shift towards the darker side and South Pole shift toward the lighter side, from dark to light, and North Pole from light to dark, from day to that is why North Pole and South Pole for about 6 months till Earth does not reach here, they experience North Pole continuously night, from here to here continuously night, and from South Pole from here to here continuously day. So at this time, the whole surface of the Earth is having equal length of day and night. That is called equinox. It is called equinox. In northern hemisphere, it is autumn equinox, and in southern hemisphere, it is spring equinox, or that occurs on 23rd September. Must remember it. Now, again, Earth move further, move forward, and reach at this position C. Again, the axis is inclined, but which axis is inclined? Which pole is inclined toward the sun? South pole. When Earth reached to this position, South pole is inclined toward the sun and North pole is away from the sun. And what is the result of it? Okay, due to inclination of the South pole, South pole always remains to the day side, and larger part, this is equator, see, from equator, and larger part of southern hemisphere faces day and very small part of it go to night side. Means for longer period of time it remains to the day side, or for very less period of time it go to the darker side. Means it is summer season in southern hemisphere, or just reverse happened to the northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere experience winter season, or it on this day sunrays fall vertically over Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degrees south latitude. And what is the result? Southern hemisphere experience summer solstice, and winter solstice occurs in northern hemisphere, or it happens on 22nd December. Next, Earth move and further reach to this position on 21st March again, when sun rays fall vertically over equator. Neither poles inclined toward the sun, all are away from this, means sun rays fall vertically over equator. So circle of illumination again passes through poles, and poles shift from darker to lighter, or lighter to darker part of the Earth for 6 months, and the day and night experience throughout the world is of 12 hours each, means equal length of day and night. And again it move and reach to this position when North Pole is inclined toward the sun on 21st June, and same. So in this way, it is this revolution take place or get completed in 365 days and 65 and 1/4 days, and seasons occur. So I think all you know, the shape of the orbit is not circle, it is elliptical as you saw on the diagram. All the things with that's all for today's class. Thank you.